Hey, Tyler Day here. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up Google Tag Manager so that you can fire a conversion event in your Google ad account when somebody clicks a button on your website. So make sure that you like and make sure that you subscribe to the channel because we're going to be dropping a lot more tutorials like this. So basically, with this type of funnel, somebody clicks through the funnel and at the end of the funnel, they're basically prompted to call. And when they stay on the line for more than 2 minutes, we get paid for that call. Now, the challenge is that the tracking for actually tracking back a billable call of somebody that stayed on the line for more than 2 minutes, the attribution of those conversions can be very wonky and inconsistent. So the method that we prefer to use for tracking is to track the people that click on this call to action button as our conversion event. So this is basically a preliminary metric showing how many people have clicked the call to action button on our funnel and have called into the call center where we get paid if they stay on the line for more than 2 minutes. So this is basically the event that we are using as our conversion objective for the campaign. So in order to get your conversion pixel to fire on this click call to action, basically what we need to do is set up Google Tag Manager. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you exactly how to do this. Like I said, make sure that you like, make sure that you give this a subscribe, and let's get into it. Okay, so the first thing that you're going to do is you are going to go to tagmanager.google.com and you're going to click on Create Account. And what you're going to name the account is basically just your domain name. So I'm going to use this demo domain here. And what we're going to do, we're going to put that name in the account name and also the container name. And under the target platform, we're going to select web. And then go ahead and click on create. And where it prompts you to agree to the terms of service, click on yes. Okay, and then we're going to use this information to install Google Tag Manager. So really the page that you want to install this on is on the, you can install this on each page of your landing page if you want, but really where it's most important to install this is on the call to action page of your landing page where you're going to click to call. So what you're going to do is you're going to follow these instructions. So you're going to paste this code in the header of the page, and then you're going to paste this additional code after the opening body tag. Okay. Now, if you are using the Unbounce page builder, which is a page builder that we recommend for building lead generation funnels, there's a shortcut to install the Google Tag Manager. So what you do is you copy this little tag in the code here, and you go over to Unbounce, and on the left-hand side, go to Settings, go to Script Manager, click on Add a Script. When it asks, what would you like to add, click on Google Tag Manager and paste in the container ID. And then what you can do is you can search for the domain that you would like to use the Google Tag Manager on. So we're going to select this example domain. We're going to press save and publish script. And this takes a few minutes to load, but once this is saved, you'll be all good to go. So now that we have the Google Tag Manager installed on our domain, what we need to do now is we need to create the Google tag in the ad account. So what we're going to do, we're going to go over to the ad account that we're going to be running ads in, and you're going to click on Tools and Settings. You're going to click on Google Tag under the Setup column. You're going to click on your Google tag here. And then you're going to grab this destination ID. So with the destination ID copy to your clipboard. We're going to go back to the tag manager. And we're going to go make sure that you're on the right domain. Go to tags. Click on new tag. We're going to name this Google Tag. Under the tag type, we're going to select Google Ads Remarketing. And we are going to paste in our conversion ID. Make sure there's no extra spaces or anything like that. And under triggering, we are going to select all pages. And we're going to click save. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to test that the integration is working. So what we're going to do, we're going to click on the preview button in the top right-hand corner. And we are going to put in the URL for our landing page, specifically the call to action page that we wish to fire the pixel from. So we're going to put in that URL and we're going to press connect. Okay. We can see that the page is coming up here. Okay. So we are going to close out of this now. Press continue. And we can see that the tag has fired. So that means that it's integrated properly. Okay, so now what we need to do is we need to set up the conversion event so that when somebody clicks on that call button, the click to call button, that a conversion event actually fires from that button. So what we're gonna do here, we're going to go back to the Google Manager homepage here. Make sure you got the right domain. We're going to click on variables. And we are going to click on configure the variables here. And we are going to select off all of the variables that have to do with a click. Okay. And then what we're going to do, we're going to go back to triggers. We're going to click on new triggers. We're going to name this click call to action, click CTA. So we're going to click in the trigger configuration box, and where it says choose a trigger type, we're going to select click all elements, and we're going to press save. Okay, next thing we're going to do, we're going to click on preview, and we're going to load up that call to action page again where we have somebody click to call. I had my pop-ups blocked here, so let me refresh. Okay, and then what we're going to do is we're going to click on this button, okay? And it's going to prompt a call. We don't actually need to call. We just need to click on the button, okay? Then what we're going to do, we're going to head over to the click area here, and we're going to click on variables. And then we can see all the variables that are associated with that click event. Okay, so we can see that the click text here contains the word call. So what we're going to do, we are going to copy this word call, and we are going to go back to the Google Tag Manager, back to the triggers area, and we're going to edit this trigger. So right now it says this trigger fires on all clicks. We're going to change this to say some clicks, and we're going to say some clicks fire this trigger when an event occurs and all these conditions are true. We're going to say click text contains the word call. So now what we need to do is we need to make the conversion event for that click in our ad account. So we're going to click on tools and settings in the ad account that you're going to be running ads in. You are going to go to the measurement column and click on conversions. Then what we're going to do, we're going to click on new conversion action. Select the kind of conversions you want to track. We're going to select website. Now we're going to put in our website domain and click on scan. We're going to scroll down to where it says create conversion actions manually. We're going to click on add conversion action manually. Under the goal and action optimization area here, we are going to select outbound click. And For the conversion name, we're going to name this CTA click, so somebody that clicked on our call to action button. And under the value area, we're not going to use a value for this conversion because there's really no real dollar amount associated with somebody just clicking on the button. And under count, we're going to select every, and we're going to click done, and then click save and continue. So the next thing that we need to do is we need to tie this conversion action that we just set up in the ad account back to Google Tag Manager. So what we're going to do, we're going to click on the use Google Tag Manager tab here. We're going to go back to the Tag Manager. We're going to click on tags. And we're going to create a new tag, which we're going to call CTA click. Okay, under the tag configuration, we are going to select Google Ads conversion tracking. For the conversion ID, we're going to grab this string here and paste that in the conversion ID tab. Where it says conversion label, we are going to select this label under the conversion action that we made. Okay, and we're going to go down and where it says triggering, we are going to tie this back to that click call CTA trigger that we made and press save. So this isn't live yet, so what we need to do is we need to test this configuration and then press submit. So we're going to press preview here. We're going to click on the call button, close out of the screen, press continue. And we can see now that the tag has fired here. So that means that it's functioning properly. So we're going to go back to the Google Tag Manager. We're going to press submit. And you don't actually need to put anything in here, but just press publish, skip, and it'll go ahead and publish this. So the last thing that we need to do is we need to set up a conversion linker. So we're going to go back to the workspace in the Tag Manager. And where it says up here, add conversion linker, we are going to click on add tag. We're going to name this conversion linker. We are, it's already set up there. We're going to click on save. We're going to click on submit, publish. And once we publish that conversion linker, you should be all set up. So now if you're using any landing page on the domain that we set up Google Tag Manager on, as long as the call to action button has that call text in the call to action button, your conversion event will fire on that. So when you're setting up your campaign on Google, just make sure that you're selecting that outbound click event as your conversion event. Usually when we're setting up these type of campaigns, we're using the lead objective and then we're optimizing for that outbound click event. Anyways, that's how you set it up. Hey, so one thing that I want to add is that we actually have an affiliate network where you can sell your calls to us. So we'll actually buy calls from you for verticals like ACA health insurance, debt relief, car insurance. So feel free to contact me on Skype. My Skype ID is tdayskype123. We also buy leads, so you can run regular lead gen campaigns with us, and we'll buy leads in other verticals like car loan, solar, home improvement, windows, and all sorts of different verticals. So reach out on Skype if you're an affiliate, and I'll talk to you soon.